We wanted to observe how sex and species-specific playback vocalizations would affect the attention responses of the mallard ducks. We hypothesized that if a sex-specific playback vocalization was broadcasted, then the opposite sex of the same species would have an increase in attention responses due to the importance of auditory stimulus to ducks during sexual imprinting.
During the study, we observed five different attention responses. One of the responses included swimming away from the vocalization. Another response that was observed during the study was the duck swimming toward the playback, as seen here with the single male mallard duck. The two ducks seen here exhibited a less frequently seen behavior, erecting their feathers. The fourth attention response that was observed was the mallards turning their heads and looking around to search for the vocalization. The last attention response that was seen, or more heard, was quacking in response to the call, "Listen here."
One of the calls that was used as a playback was a male mallard call. The attention responses were calculated as percentages to better visualize the data. Based on this, there wasn't an increase in a certain sex because of the call. However, there were more responses from the same species, mallard, than the American black ducks also seen along the red cedar. The second call that was used as a playback was a male American black duck call. The data shown here reinforces the idea that the data is not attracting the opposite sex. It also disproves the idea that the calls were attracting the same sex. Looking at this graph allows one to see that there's a slight skew in the sample size favoring the mallard ducks. Another call that was used was the female mallard vocalization. In this graph, it is easy to see that the female mallard call evoked more responses than the male call from all sexes and species of ducks. The last vocalization that was used as a playback was the female American black duck vocalization. In this graph, one can see very clearly that all percentages of responses were higher across populations. Due to that, one can conclude that female vocalizations are far more important than male vocalizations in ducks.
After the duck study, we wanted to find a homologous behavior in humans. We tested the attention responses and replied to a playback call. We hypothesized that if a sex-specific human call was played, then the opposite sex would exhibit more attention responses because humans are hardwired to find a mate to reproduce with. Two attention responses were observed, looking toward the vocalization and becoming confrontational toward the researchers.
The first call used in the human study was a male-human vocalization. Easily seen in the graph, there was a sex-specific response exhibited by the females, although not significant due to the lack of sample size. The second call used in the human study was a female-human vocalization. Reinforcing the inference from the male call, the males exhibited a sex-specific response as well, although it is also not significant due to the lack of sample size.
In both humans and mallard ducks, there is an HSD1 gene that codes for an enzyme that creates a corticosteroid that is elevated during auditory stimulus. We have already collected and preserved 7 feathers and have IB3 cells of humans on standby. Further genetic testing is underway.
This study has allowed us to determine the homologous communication behaviors between mallard ducks and humans at Michigan State University. This gave us insight as to the evolutionary and genetic background of attention responses, which is important to illustrate the evolutionary pathway between birds and primates. Even though this study has great impact on science as a whole, it all happened on the banks of the Red Cedar.